man, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
What a joy it is for you to join in today as we celebrate the 26th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Just to mention a few days after our chicken barbecue and the wonderful success that was, how wonderful it is to come around this altar and thank God for his many blessings. As we move into this fall season all the more, God continually calls us to grow and take root, just like those trees outside that are changing colors, to also change our lives this season. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of your will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say, the Lord's way is not there. Hear now, house of Israel. Is it my way that is unfair? Or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from the wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life, since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed. He shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord.
Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me. For you are God, my Savior.
Remember.
The sins of my youth and my frailties remember not. In your kindness, remember me because of your goodness, O Lord.
Remember your mercies, O Lord.
Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice and teaches the humble his way.
Remember your mercies, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind. same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also for those of others. Have in your same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who though he was not in the form of God, did not regard equality from God, something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw him, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We're a couple weeks out from the Bills home opener, so I can say this. I have to tell you, I was so impressed with Josh Allen. He's only 24 years old, and he may have been the highest draft pick in Bills history, but I think we all have to admit he's growing the position when you look at our Buffalo Bills. And at the home opener, they beat the Jets 27-17, and I have to tell you, it just lit up my day. If we were to go back, though, 2 years, if you remember in the fall of 2018, not long ago, everybody said it would be a growing season for him and be a growing season for all of our Buffalo Bills. But they opened up that season, 2018, this is, against the Baltimore Ravens, and they only scored 3 points. They actually lost 3-47 for the Baltimore team. The following week was a home opener against the Los Angeles Chargers, and a man named Fontaine Davis quit at halftime. And there's a video of him in the parking lot of One Bills Drive, where he's a 10-year veteran for the NFL. But he's taking off his protective equipment, putting it in the truck. He had told no one, he wasn't injured, nothing, just walks out in the middle of at halftime. And he abruptly quits, and he says that he's retiring. And he hops into his car as he's driving away. He tells the world, "Don't forget to send me a check. I played half the game." To the ESPN, they were stunned. to the team, gosh, they were stunned. And in fact, even the head coach could not really make comment about it because he was probably too personally involved. I think it teaches all of us we have to stay in the game. There's ups and downs in our life, but we have to persevere. We have to be the one that puts our hands and our feet into this mission that we call Christ's mission, or being a Christian. Because not only does God need us, but also all of our teammates, the body of Christ needs us. When people quit halfway through, you know what? It just doesn't work out for any of us. It's that ripple effect. I think we've all met people along the way that don't follow through. Nobody likes a phony. Nobody likes someone inauthentic or somebody without integrity. And I think in this world, you know, there's the morals of the marketplace that we're always battling against. But every one of us has been in restaurants where maybe we ordered a drink that never comes. Or maybe we called somebody and we're not even sure if they'll call us back. Or how many times have you wanted to count on something that you didn't know, could I even trust that they would follow through? When it comes to our faith life, it's the same thing. I know many a person who says that they really plan on going to Sunday Mass or participating online, but never get around to doing it. People will also say they change, but you know what? Sometimes they don't even try. And so as we hear these readings today, as we just begin the fall season, it's really about growing your faith life, about using the gifts and talents that God has given us, and not being like Fontaine Davis, walking out at halftime, but staying in the game and growing in integrity. We are now in the 21st chapter of Matthew's Gospel. So we're getting closer to the end of the year. And now we're starting to deal with the animosity and struggles between Jesus and the church leaders. So Jesus uses this particular parable to aim it squarely at these church leaders. But you know, in reality, he's doing it for all of us too. All of us need a wake-up call like today. Because so often, they thought they were righteous, but I can tell you there's a lot of times in my life that I think I'm righteous too. But when I start fooling myself that way, I kind of stop changing. And that's why I hear this message today. God always wants to stretch us, even when we think we're doing well. But so he literally asks the question today, what do you think as we open up the gospel? Doesn't fold it over them, doesn't lord it over them. He gives them the time. And I think in the beauty of the liturgical year, if we don't get one parable, we've got another one coming at us to help us change the following week. But today, in order to get the people in the gospel and all of us to think about our actions, it's designed to ask ourselves, are we really authentically doing the best that we can when it comes to our faith life? Think of the beauty of the outdoors now that the fall's beginning. You know, now it's a time of apple cider, it's a time for football games, it's a time for pumpkins, it's a time for those sunflower patches. And so it's a beauty of a season, one of the most beautiful seasons of the year. But it's also a time for us to show our interior beauty and let it radiate out. The beauty of our gospel, I think St. Augustine says it so well, is that the word of God is closer to us than ourselves. Meaning God's got us figured out. And he gives us this reading today to help us. It may be this reading, but perhaps it's the road to Emmaus in chapter 24 of Luke, in which he's trying to draw people on the road and journey with them. Maybe it's Mary Magdalene in chapter 16 at Easter Sunday, who loses the fact that it's Jesus there, thinks he's the gardener. God works on us and he can bait us. Draw somebody really, really wants us to grow. He wants us to get stronger every week. So what he does today is he poses this question to them, because there are tax collectors and prostitutes, those considered the least in the kingdom of God. And you know what Jesus is basically saying? They're getting into heaven first because they're working on it themselves. They may not think they've got it all figured out, but they're anchoring on Jesus, and they're saying, Lord, in our sinfulness, call us. Call us to be all the better. Help us change. And they honestly are taking an honest look at themselves, knowing that they're not perfect. And they're also telling all of us, not the Pharisees and the scribes, but it's actually the tax collectors that are teaching us, that you know what, I have to be the one that says I'm going to follow through. So Jesus gives us this parable of two sons, and there's a tension between saying and doing. Every one of us would agree, actions speak a lot louder than words. I can say I'm going to do something, but will I actually do it? That's the recipe of these two sons. One son says it really clearly, I'm not going to do it. But then that God within is saying, you know what, you got to do it. You got to be supportive of your father. You have to do that work. All of us could say the same thing, whether we're a mom or dad or a brother or sister, or whether we're just a friend along the journey. How many times have we faced a scenario where we say, we're not going to do it. We will not do it, God. I won't do it. But then you know what, we think about it and pray about it. You know what we say, Lord, you're right, and I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it for you, and I'm going to do it for your greater glory, and I'm not going to quit. I'm going to do it to make it a better world. Sometimes, though, we have to admit, sometimes we take the other side, where we say, yeah, I will do something, and then never follow through. None of us want to admit it. I don't want to admit it either. You know, I'm just like you. But at the same time, it's true. And I think St. Ignatius of Loyola tells us to every day close our day with an examination of conscience. Where were we successful? Where did perhaps maybe we could have did better? But it teaches us in this parable that a change of heart and a change of mind is always possible. Because with God, we can do so many things. We can think that we will never do something. But you know what? God's got another plan. And he gives us another parable and another situation and another life circumstance trying to get the better of us all. I think all one needs to do is look at the two thieves on either side of Jesus on the fire. One says, I'm sinful, I make mistakes. But Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. The other one says, help me anyway. You know, and which one does Jesus call out? Probably that tax collector or that sinner. The one there that's the thief saying, today you will be with me in paradise. Or maybe we just need to look at Mary who anointed Jesus in one of our weekday gospels just a few days ago, a little bit over a week ago, where in that anointing, she bathes Jesus with her own tears, his feet, and dries them with her hair. And Jesus makes it very, very clear that her sins will be forgiven. It's letting the greater glory of God work on you and change you now that all is begun. We have an opportunity this particular Sunday to say, I will do that work in the kingdom. I'll do that work in my relationships with God, but I'm also going to do it in my relationship with God by perhaps working harder in my family. And I'm going to do better in my relationship with God by perhaps reconciling with one of my friends. Or I'm going to do it in my relationship with God to help out someone who might be down and out. Or I'm going to do it in my relationship with God by practicing the patience or practicing the kindness or knowing that God is calling me to my better self. We have the ability, and by examining our conscience every day, we can answer that question. Which son are we today? Which son do we want to be? We know that God calls every one of us all the time. And so we need to know where he's calling, open up our hearts, and move to the light by actually doing what we're saying we're going to do and living our life with an honesty and integrity. Our world could be so much better if all of us followed this gospel. The Lord who has given us all these so many blessings, God's calling you and I. May you pray today, what's he calling you to do? And may you be like that son who puts your money and your time and your heart where your mouth is. That here you follow the Lord to whatever path he calls, and will make it a better world as one united body of Christ with the Lord at its head. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I invite you to join in our apostles' creed as we renew our baptismal promises, calling us to lead faithful lives of integrity. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Called to be disciples that are trustworthy and leading lives of integrity, let us offer our prayers to the Lord with confidence, knowing that in love, God waits for us to turn to him. For the Holy Church on earth, and for all the faithful, for you and I, may the power of the Holy Spirit help us to love one another and live in unity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of authority, whether it be in our marriage, our family, in our workplace, in our school, in all of our relationships, may the Lord lead all of us in our efforts toward protecting all of God's people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unemployed and the underemployed, especially at this time of pandemic, we pray for all the ways in which we're in need of God's healing graces. We pray for our parasitics. May God, in his goodness, help us to find work that will provide for our needs, and also healing for our wounds, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safe community of St. John the 23rd, may we grow in mercy and compassion, joyfully imitating Christ our Savior, and being his hands and his feet in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith, we pray in a special way for the deceased members of the Matucci, Thomas, and the Vittoria families, for Jack Monroe, Geraldine Shabasi, Reverend Monsignor Kevin T. O'Neill, Jim Quinn, and Agnes Koch. May they and all the faithful departed, may they rejoice with the saints in God's everlasting kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those prayers that we voice now in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
The Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Father, for your steadfast love and abundant grace. Please hear and answer our prayers this day according to your holy will. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice be yours, may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father, mercies, and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end, we acclaim.
Holy.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Our brothers and sisters, to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone know. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us in our earthly pilgrimages, God, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs and all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Our prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe in your presence in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot in this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Remember your word to your servant, O Lord, by which you have given me whole. This is my comfort when I am brought low. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs and Lord with Christ, in whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
What a joy it is for you to join with me today as we pray this Mass together. Our class of first reconciliation students celebrates the sacrament tomorrow evening. So please pray for our little kids, our young youth, that they may just be more and more nurtured and growing in that faith. I hope to see you around this altar soon. Our Sunday Saturday Mass is at 4 p.m. Our Sunday Mass is at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m. with the weekday Mass at 8:30 in the morning. Our bulletin's available right on our website, stjohn23.com. We will have a blessing of animals as we open up the month of October in honor of St. Francis of Assisi and our Franciscan roots here at the parish. And there's also a blood drive that's upcoming during the month of October. So stay tuned to all of our activities and come around this glorious altar table. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.